Namaste, viewers. Welcome to Jnana Degula channel. Today, we will try to understand the meaning of Advaita consciousness. We'll try to understand those words. But before we go to the topic, I request you to please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Now, coming back. Advaita Vedanta, or what learning, is one of the most profound Indian philosophical system. It is the peak of the thought, philosophical thought in India. So it was there, this thought was there, but it was consolidated and then made, make it more clear by Sri Adi Shankaracharya. He was a very brilliant thinker. Of course, all these thoughts he drew from ancient texts, ancient Upanishads, Vedas, and all those things. There were, even to this day, the Swami Vivekananda, Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, many people, try to explain the idea of consciousness and self, what is consciousness and self, in ways that are still relevant today. Now, what is this consciousness? How it is viewed from the Advaita Vedanta? According to Adi Shankara, Atman, the soul, and Brahman, the ultimate reality. There are two things, Atman, soul, and the ultimate reality are essentially what we call, or both are essentially one and the same. This Atman is pure consciousness. Eternal, it is unchanging and self-luminous. That means it is all how it is to be defined, how it is to be understood. Self-luminous means it appears, it shines it with its own light, that is, with its own luminescence. That means it doesn't depend on anything else to be known. Rather, it is what makes everything else known, through which only you can know everything. This is how it is defined, Brahman. Think of it as a light that allows you to see everything in the dark room. Just like objects can't reveal themselves in darkness, likewise, our physical reality can't exist without consciousness. So now, in everyday life, we identify ourselves as a Jiva, as life, as living force, as individual self, which appears that it is separate from everything else. So whatever that we see around, it is separate everything else. But according to Advaita, this separation, that what we are and then what we see, all those things and all kinds of things, it is an illusion caused by our limiting perceptions. The perceptions are limited, therefore we think that everything is different. So really, if you think of it, our true nature, the Atman, is free from constraints of time, constraints of nature, constraints of space and activity also. So it appears to be involved in the world, but in truth, it is ever liberated. It is not a part of this world. It's ever liberated. And beyond the physical limitations, we experience. This is the essence of non-duality. Meaning that everything is part of one universal consciousness. So now, what is this consciousness? It is the foundation of the universe. In the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, one of the ancient texts in Vedanta, states that consciousness is the ultimate reality. This cosmic consciousness is the foundation of everything in the universe, including whatever you call it, matter, energy. So in modern times, this would be saying that everything we see, stars, planets, ourselves, this earth, whatever that is happening in the earth, comes from the very subtle form of energy. And that is connected to consciousness. If we compare this to the findings of modern science, such as quantum physics, we can think of consciousness as the force behind all energy and matter. Some even make a playful analogy to the spiritual particle. You can call it a spiricon, something like this, you know, like a Higgins boson in physics, which represents the union of spirit and consciousness, forming the fabric of reality. So now, there are two, three types of consciousness. You can try to categorize into different levels, you can say. That is, one it is called as Brahma Chaitanya. That means absolute consciousness. This is the highest form of consciousness, the ultimate truth that encompasses everything. Brahma Chaitanya encompasses everything. This is of the, highest order, something like that. Now, there is one more next to that, you can call it as Ishwara Chaitanya. It's not a level, it is one type. This cosmic consciousness, we can say this, Ishwara. This pervades the universe, often associated with God or the cosmic order. God means some cosmic order. Now there is one more term known as Jiva Chaitanya. Jiva Chaitanya means at an individual level, individual consciousness. This is the level of consciousness that we experience as individuals. That is like the awareness which we experience in our daily lives. This is one. Now, you can, you will have one more term, one more way as Sakshi Chaitanya. What is Sakshi? Sakshi means witness. It is just simply observing. This is detached from everything. It is a observer, detached observer within us. The part of consciousness that watches everything. It's only just observing, and it doesn't involve in any of these things. It is like a silent spectator. silent witness to all our experiences. This is, so you can think of three, four things. One is Brahma Chaitanya, Ishvara Chaitanya, Jiva Chaitanya, and Sakshi Chaitanya. Now, what does all these things mean to us? See, this Advaita teaches us that the separations we see in life between ourselves and others, between good, bad, between life, death, all these things, whatever we see, you know, different forms, are all illusions. They are all illusions and they are all interconnected through consciousness. The individual self, Jiva, is not separate from the cosmic self. It is not at all. So, once we understand this, the perception this way, we can break free from the cycle of fear, anxiety, attachment to worldly things, realizing our true nature and liberated nature. See, after all these things, you know, this understanding and whatever we, they should have a purpose, na? The purpose is that break free from cycle of fear, anxiety, attachment, all those things, you know, we realize that, once we realize this. So, this Advaita Vedanta encourages us to see beyond the surface, recognize that we are part of something much larger, not here, much larger picture. It's a philosophy that helps us find peace in knowing that the essence of life is one, undivided consciousness, and we are all part of it. This is one. So, to summarize, this Vedanta offers a profound understanding of consciousness, blending spiritual wisdom with logical thought. It suggests that the universe and everything in it, including our sense of self, it all comes from one ultimate source. So now, as we try to understand this, as we go deeper into it, we can find peace, we can find clarity, we can understand the deeper connection to the world around us. Of course, it can be through meditation, study, introspection, whatever you call it. See, everything is same only. Meditation, study, introspecting, and all those things, you know, they are all various tools. That's all. This Advaita gives us the tools to realize our true nature and see beyond the illusions of everyday life. This is the conclusion. So, with this, viewers, we will conclude this episode. We'll move further in our other videos. Till then, goodbye and thank you for watching this video. I hope you have liked it. Please, as a mark of your liking, please press that like button, like, share, and then subscribe to my channel. Thank you.